right? Alright, so the block of Shadow Fiends is better, if you notice. Let's go to free camera right now. Why can't I move? Let's click Shadow Fiend. Fog, I can't see both fog. Alright, let's play a little bit and pause. Alright, now it's... Can I move? Why am I not able to move? Alright, whatever. So right now, the problem is, like, it's the best block. Like, it's not the best block, but it's a really good block for Shadow Fiend. All he has to do is sit back here. He's not gonna get harassed by Storm Spirit, and he's not gonna harass too, because if Shadow Fiend harasses Storm Spirit, maybe he can give one right click. Like, he can go. What I would do is I'd go out of the 500 aggro range of the creep, and then I'll right click Storm so the creeps don't aggro. The idea basically is now if he stands here, if he stands here somewhere and starts attacking Storm Spirit, these creeps will start hitting Shadow Fiend. So he has to be pretty careful, as in, like, he shouldn't let... Can I move? Alright. So if he starts attacking Storm Spirit, the creeps will come up to Shadow Fiend, and then these creeps will go down to this range creep, and you don't want that. This is, like, the best creep line, I would say. So you have to make sure that the Shadow Fiend has to make sure that he doesn't mess up the creep line. Obviously, the Storm is gonna, like, A-click Shadow Fiend and pull the... Generally, he should do that as a good player. He should pull all these creeps back to the range creep so he can last it better. Alright, this is what I would do. And let's see what the Storm's doing. Let's go back here, click the player's perspective. He's probably gonna aggro the creeps. He just does not have vision.
Denied.
He's not pulling aggro. I don't know why he should actually do that, but the Storm is not doing there. I don't know what's the reason behind it. He's just making it easier for Shadow Fiend. Okay, let's see what he did right here. So what he's doing is these are all, like, small. You probably don't see it, but what he's doing is basically okay. So what's gonna happen is, if you check it from Shadow Fiend's perspective, Shadow Fiend wants this range creep, right? He wants this range creep, and to get that range creep, he has to stand somewhere here, right? He will stand somewhere here to hit. Shadow Fiend's not at that. Or probably here. If he stands here, it's bad for Shadow Fiend, because Storm's gonna easily deny the range creep. Because the closer you are to the creep, the easier for you it is to last it or deny. So Shadow Fiend's gonna try to be slightly close to the creeps to last it this creep, right? So he knows the Shadow Fiend's gonna go to last it this creep. And Storm Spirit has a remnant which does 140 damage, and this creep right here is about that HP. So what Storm can do at this time is walk up to Shadow Fiend right here and use his remnant, so he gets the CS. And if Shadow Fiend stays here to deny this, to last it this creep, then he's gonna take remnant damage from Storm Spirit. What Shadow Fiend will have to do is, he sees Storm walking up to remnant, he should actually back stand here and try to last it. But if he does that, Storm is just gonna get a deny out of this creep, or he might just go for the harass. I don't know what he decides to do. But these are, like, small things that you play a lot. Like, I probably don't do this, like, I forget to do this, but I know what he's trying to do. Then, like, if you play a lot, lots and lots of, if you play a lot with this hero, then, or any hero for that matter, you kind of know that you can do certain things to get an advantage. So this is what Storm's going to do. He's going to walk up, and he's going to remnant. You see that? So SF didn't get the last hit, right? And he took the damage, SF took the damage of his static remnant, okay? Now, This is what all Storm Spirit should do when they play against a melee hero, is that every time the melee hero comes to last hit a creep, you can zone him out, that you can force him not to last hit the creep, right? And if he does anyway come for the last hit, you can use a remnant and harass him. So for every last hit the melee hero hits, the remnant is gonna do a damage. So this guy is actually he's playing even better. Even though Shadow Fiend's a ranged hero, he's using the advantage of the Remnant zone, right? The Remnant has a range of, I think, like, how much is the range? It's like this small range. I think it's like, I don't know the exact number, but I kind of know the range. It's like this big range, so it's pretty big. All right. See, Shadow Fiend's probably gonna go. He denied it. All right, he's denying. Shadow Fiend's denied it too. So right now, Shadow Fiend's like really. Now he's probably gonna Remnant. So this is something every Shadow Fiend, every Storm Spirit will do. So what I would have done too. So right now, he's just denying the Shadow Fiend, and he's gonna deny the Shadow Fiend only because Shadow Fiend has 40 damage. You see that? He has 40 damage, okay? But Storm has 63 damage. And if Storm stays close to the creeps, Storm can stay close to the creep because he has 6 armor and Shadow Fiend has 2 armor, right? So if Shadow Fiend hits Storm, it doesn't damage Storm so much because he's Shadow Fiend just has 40 damage and he has a salve anyway, right? Sorry, Storm has a salve anyway. So you can stay close to the creep and make it harder because 40 damage, you can't last it when a storm, if a good storm can last it these creeps. So he's playing really well. The storm is really good at last hitting. Now, you might think, oh, this is not too hard, but it is actually hard. Like, you have to be really good at last hitting to have lane presence like this. Like, if you stand here, right? And if you miss the deny and you let him last hit, you are not being good, right? You have to be really good at last hitting too. So he is really good at last hitting. So he's gonna deny this creep. So see that? And now this creep is getting low. So Shadow Fiend is gonna try to deny this creep, right? Definitely. He's gonna try to deny this creep. What Storm can do is he knows. He already checked, like I'm pretty sure he already checked Shadow Fiend. If Shadow Fiend has any salve or whatever, he basically wants Shadow Fiend to use a salve. So what he's gonna do is he's gonna remnant this creep. If you remnant, there's no way Shadow Fiend can deny a remnant to the creep at 40 damage, right? And not only does he gets the CS, he also gets a right click off, and each right click does an extra 30 damage. That is 60 plus 30. That's like 90 damage, right? So every little bit of damage he does on Shadow Fiend, one right click, even one right click, guys, is really good. Because Shadow Fiend only has 300 HP. He does like 60 damage. So he hits 3 times Shadow Fiend. Shadow Fiend has like half of this bar is reduced, like somewhere here, 3 hits. But Remnant hit is gonna go somewhere here, and Shadow Fiend's forced, really forced to salve. So this guy is also probably a good player. So he knows that he can't come close and stay in the range of Storm. He's staying back because as soon as he comes close, Storm's gonna keep right clicking him, and Remnant right clicking him, and then he's forced to use the salve, and then he doesn't even have a single last hit. So he's gonna use the salve as late as possible, right? So the Storm's gonna abuse this. Watch this. So he's gonna Remnant, hit it. So look at this HP, so low, right? 226. One more right click. You see that? And then let's watch some more things that are happening right here. So he remnants hit this. Now what he's doing is he knows these two creeps are really low, and these two creeps will die with one remnant, right? He can and all he has to do is remnant these creeps, and when he remnants these creeps, he can hit Shadow Fiend, and he will get these two CS, and at the same time he damages Shadow Fiend too. So this is all really calculated, like. All right, he's gonna remnant and right click. There you go. He got both the creeps and he got this, and he's trying to right click as much as possible, right? So now Shadow Fiend had to salve, right? He has to salve, and the problem is Shadow Fiend can't he now Shadow Fiend to last at this, he has to come here because that's his max range of right click, right? He has to come slightly here, but if he comes here, he can cancel Shadow Fiend's salve. Now good players, sometimes they'll sacrifice a salve for a last hit, like not sacrifice an entire salve. Maybe like this is he can get to full HP, right? If he wants to go to full HP, he cannot get this last hit. He probably cannot get this last hit either, because right now salve is buffed because it works a little faster now, I think. I'm not sure. Previously, it used to be slower, but right now, at least like the initial salve is kind of fast that it brings up the HP to a decent level. So he's gonna try to at least get this much of his HP back. So maybe he can get this last hit. But if he comes slightly close, Storm's gonna right click him, and if he right clicks him, his salve is canceled, right? And not only that, he redu every right click, he's gonna lose the damage. So he salved up and he's gonna go back to this HP bar, which kind of sucks, right? So all right, he's gonna pause. He didn't get both CS. Now the difference is like, Some people do this. Let's go to free camera. Oh my god, why can't I move in free camera? This kind of sucks. Let's do 1-0. Alright. Oh my god, I fucked up. Alright, so. Alright, so what's happening is, if you see over here, I just wanted to tell you guys what happened there. So, this is some mistake like I used to do. Like, what happens is right now, there are way too many creeps. He missed the last hit. Now, what people would do is they would like... Okay, now free camera is working for some reason. Alright. Anyway, so what they would do is they would use Storm Spirit and then they will dive into the tower. Not dive, but walk into the tower and try to deny all these creeps. Sometimes it's worth it to do it, but what's happening is he doesn't see Lion, right? If you see in the minimap, he doesn't see Lion. I don't know if Clockwork, his Queen of Pain has a ward. No, his Queen of Pain does not have a ward. He has a ward here. So he actually doesn't see the Lion. Lion might be pulling, or who knows, and he doesn't see Lone Druid or anything. Say they have a Bloodseeker or something, or Lion here, right? And then if he stands here, and then he walks up here to, like, deny these creeps. Technically, he can deny these creeps, like, at least one of these creeps he can deny. But it's like Shadow Fiend can pull these creeps, like he can aggro all these creeps and take all the creeps here, right? And then you have to walk back or walk back like this, which is just not efficient enough. Because if Lion comes in and ganks him, all this fucking wrecked Shadow Fiend, right? He has not a single lasted. All that is wasted, because if Shadow Fiend gets a kill or this guy dies, Shadow Fiend gets time to back. So this is something like good players do, but I would not recommend you to do, even if like it's not worth it. Like these three creeps, let Shadow Fiend have it. Like if you go in here and you mess up a little bit and the tower hits you and say all these creeps walk up to this part of the lane, you're fucked, right? You have no other choice. You have to walk out like this, right? And if Lion ganks you here or when you're retreating or something, you're kind of fucked. I think if the creeps go here, you can't retreat like this because the tower is going to hit you. You have to really like this, right? It's not safe, and I think this is why the Storm backs off, right? Storm just backs off. Shadow Fiend's gonna get all three last hits, hopefully. No, he doesn't. Okay, he gets two last hits. So, no, he gets one last hit. He's not gonna let him. He's probably gonna last it or Remnant. Okay. Now he has his raises up. This is where Shadow Fiend gets stronger, the raises, right? So he's trying his best right now. Every single raise Shadow Fiend gets, he's gonna Remnant. There you go. So this is another thing. Alright. These are the things like low MMR players don't even realize. But if you play a lot of mid, you will know this. Alright. Right now, what low MMR players will do is they will keep walking like this. They will keep walking back all the way here. They'll walk back, keep walking all the way here. Right? Like this. And that what that gives is, when you keep walking back like this, the Shadow Fiend's gonna keep denying this creep. Now, problem is, like, every hero has a turn rate. So, if you want to last it this creep, you have to turn, right? You have to turn and last it, okay? So, you have to also compensate for, if you want to last it, you have to also compensate for the turn and then last it. So, it's kind of a problem. So, some people, what they do is, they take this creep and they walk up like this. This way, they walk up like this way, so the creeps walk up here, and if they walk up straight down, Shadow Fiend's probably gonna right click him if he tries to last it this one, right? Or if they have an Invoker, say there's not Shadow Fiend, say there's Invoker or Wind Ranger or something, you can't get this creep. If you stand here, turn back and right click this creep, she's gonna land like three hits on you, one, two, probably four hits. Like, as soon you get that last hit, but for that last hit you will take one right, at least two right clicks from Wind Ranger, and then you have to turn around, right? You have to turn 180 to hit this creep, and then you have to turn 180 again to go back, walk back. So you'll get like four or five last hits from the enemy. So it's generally never worth it to just turn around. So either you can walk up here and then try to last it, so when this guy chases you, it's you still have a long distance, so it's safer. Or what you can do is if you have a spell, you can use it, right? Or sometimes you just like not last at this, right? But the best thing is just use the spell. Like, so this is what he's going to do. He's going to remnant this because he doesn't want to turn. Okay, remnant, right click and back off, right? Because if he stood there and he tried to like wait for the last, if he waited for the creep to go low, really low and then last it, maybe SF would have got two more right clicks on him. It's not worth it because right now you're so ahead. All right, he's gonna last it this, it's easy last it. Now, the creeps are in Storm's favor, and Shadow Fiend's gonna try to pull the creeps to his range creep as much as possible. So, this is where a lot of people do a mistake, like, they let the enemy hero pull the wave, and let's see what he's doing. I think he's gonna play aggressive, like, if he tries to pull the lane, he's just gonna walk up and start right-clicking Shadow Fiend. Okay, that's what he's doing. You see that? He's not letting him pull the wave. Because he can trade. Shadow Fiend only has one soul right now. He raised. It's fine. That was a bad salve. What the fuck? That was such a bad salve. Oh! Makes sense. Alright, I didn't even see the minimap. Alright. So, Storm actually, let's watch this. So, I didn't look at this. I look at this, but there's a, I'm telling what he's doing, but basically that was a really bad salve, the salve which he just used, but he tactically used the salve. So, he knows that there's this ally coming here to gank, right? So, he wants to probably bait the Shadow Fiend and getting like, oh, I can kill Storm Spirit or something. So, he salved up, so he's gonna try to fight Storm, and then he realizes, holy shit, there's someone here. There you go. Still, that salve was still bad. He should wait a little bit, but it's still fine because he was getting a gank. But I think it was like calculated. All right, another thing which he did, if you watch here, so he killed him, right? And he got his bottle, right? He's bottling, and the thing is, like, this is another thing I always do. Like, what you can do is you can walk up all the way and pick the rune, right? Now the problem with that is if you walk now, you bottle up, right? You can clear this wave, walk up all the way, pick the rune, and come back. But that can actually, it depends. Like, if someone picks up the rune in between, you're kind of fucked. So generally what people do is they get the bottle, and as soon as they get the bottle, they bottle crow, right? And I think that's what he's doing right now. He's getting the bottle, he's filling everything up, and he's bottle crowing. He's not going for that rune, and top rune's already taken. It's worth it to take the top rune because it's really close, but this rune is so far, right? And another thing I would say is, like, never pick up runes where you don't have vision. And if the supports are missing, don't go to that part. It's not worth it, just bottle crow. Alright, right now, you see that, what he's doing. Okay, I think he was going there, but anyway. What he's doing is, like, 53, right now, what is he gonna do as a Storm Spirit? He can't go up here and start wasting time, right? What he can do is he can go up here and stack this at 53, or 55, actually, and then come back to the lane, because there's no creeps for him to kill, right? He can be more efficient and create more farm for himself. But right now, he tried to do that, but then he realized it's just 2:45, right? 2:45 is too early. He can't just keep waiting here for like 10 seconds. In 10 seconds, the wave is going to meet. So he decided, all right, this is too late, like, or too early, and he's going to walk up, right? He's going to walk up because the wave's going to meet, and it's not going to be worth it. He can't let Shadow. And now, he has to be careful because he can get hit by raises. So, all right, there's another thing he's doing. Like, what's this? The thing is, like, right now, a lot of people make this mistake. I've seen this even at like 4K, whatever. Like, people walk up to Shadow Fiend at this range and try to like right click him. They'll put a remnant right in between the creeper and try to right click Shadow Fiend. That's so bad because Shadow Fiend will use his raises, which do a shit ton of damage. It's 175, 175. That's a lot of damage. It's more than your shitty overload damage, right? And not only that, like, when the creeps are low, Shadow Fiend will get their last hit and he will get a harass out of you. So you have to be careful in standing somewhere here so you don't take raise damage. So if he wants to raise you, he has to only raise you, and he won't get the creeps. So generally, he won't do that, because the most efficient way to use your raises is to use it on the creeps, and also use it on the enemy, right? So if you walk up as a Storm Spirit right here, it is efficient to use a raise to kill the creep, because you're damaging the enemy and you're getting a last hit, right? So that's what he's going to do. He's going to walk up here so he's safer and try to last hit, try to deny as possible. So Shadow Fiend's not going to waste his raises unless he really is like right now. I might have raised for the bottle, but I think I don't know if it's low. I might raise for the bottle, but I think like at that very moment, Storm is going for his last hit, not the deny. So another trick, like right now, I think you can say Shadow Fiend kind of did this. So there's a lot of things happening in mid lane, like you don't even realize. Like, all right, so what Shadow Fiend is gonna think is thinking right now is this is another thing like you have to think about, right? So now Storm has two options, okay? If Shadow Fiend didn't have level 2 raise, right? Let alone raise doesn't hurt so much. So what he can do is he can remnant this creep and right click Shadow Fiend. And if Shadow Fiend goes for this last hit, he takes harass from Storm Spirit. And his level 1 raises don't do much. But right now he has level 2 raises which do a shit ton of damage, right? Two raises, melee and medium raise do a lot of damage, right? So Storm can either take this last hit or deny this, okay? So what I would do is, but if he hits this too early, then Shadow Fiend will try to deny this and then take the last hit. So if you have only two choices. If you want the deny and the last hit, to last it you have to use your remnant, and to deny you use your auto attack, because you can't use two auto attacks at the same time. You can't deny and last it at the same time. So if you want to guarantee a last hit against a Shadow Fiend, this is what you can do, right? You make sure that you get both the Shadow Fiend's creep that he wants to last it and your creep that you want to last it to the same HP. And Shadow Fiend will have to make the decision whether he wants to last it or he wants to deny. And most of the times, every player will go for the last it, not the deny. And then you get the last it, he gets the last it. Okay, but right now this is slightly higher HP, so Storm has like a small window where he can last hit this and deny this, maybe. But generally after last hitting a creep, your hero has a animation where he brings back his hand and throws it back again. So that's too much time, and in that time Shadow Fiend can just be really clever and last hit this. But if Shadow Fiend goes for the deny of this, then he might miss the last hit. So let's see what happens here. Alright, see, that's the mistake Shadow Fiend did, right? He made that mistake. He made the mistake that I just talked about, okay? Alright, let's see. So, he is walking up, right? He's going for the deny. Alright, let's go back again. Go forward again. Alright. Alright, so you see that? Let's go back again. Play this. Alright. Let's make it 0.25. All right. So I'm doing all the laning analysis because this is very important, right? So if you see that, Shadow Fiend's going for the deny. He should have just gone for the last hit and ignored the deny. So he would have got the last hit. Storm could not have denied that, right? If he just went for the last hit and ignored the deny. That's the mistake Shadow Fiend did, because he should know that Storm can deny and last hit at the same time. So these small difference make, anyway, this just, that was kind of a small mistake, but it's fine. So basically, these are all, like, laning mechanics and a lot of, like, you play a lot of 1v1s. You get, 1v1s are basically mid-matchups, you become really good. So, he's doing that, because another thing that I just looked like, which I do also. So, what I do right now is, what people will do with this hero, like any mid hero in this particular part of the lane, is they will just walk up back. They'll walk back, and this is so bad, and I'll tell you why. Because when you walk back, this tower starts hitting these creeps, alright? And when tower starts hitting these creeps, it becomes harder for you to last it, right? And not only that, Tower is killing these creeps fast. Okay? And what happens is this wave, these two creeps will die really quickly, and this wave will start pushing here, and then it will come back to mid. But if you, like, tank these creeps, like, don't let the creeps cross this tower range. The tower range is still here. So if you stand here and don't let these creeps go to the tower range, then these creeps will start fighting these creeps a little bit, and it will, and then the lane will freeze here, somewhere here, okay? Which is good for you. So, and also, you don't have to worry about Shadow Fiend hitting you, because Shadow Fiend is hitting you from low ground, right? Shadow Fiend is hitting you from the low ground, and you are on the high ground. And you can actually right-click Shadow Fiends from the high ground, and it's likely that you will not, it's likely that he might miss a lot, miss some right clicks on you, but you won't miss because you're on high ground. And also, there's one case where this is not right to do, is if there are too many of his creeps, like say there are four creeps, if there are four creeps here instead of like two creeps that are really low, then it's not a good idea to stand here, because those four creeps will hit you, and then Shadow Fiend will fucking wreck your face. Because the four creeps are hitting you, but you don't want to do that. In that case, what high MMR players do is they walk back like this. Oh, if the creeps are coming, they walk back like this, here, like this, into this part of the lane. So the creeps get stuck here, and it's out of the tower range, right? You walk up here and let the creeps meet here, right? But right now, it's really good. Like, two creeps, not a big deal. And this creep doesn't do much damage, right? I mean, it does damage, but Storm can just get rid of that creep with one remnant. He can just remnant, and if Shadow Fiend tries to, like, right-click him, he can remnant that creep and start right-clicking Shadow Fiend if he tries to, like, trade with Shadow Fiend. Or if Shadow Fiend tries to trade with Storm Spirit. So right now, he was just stopping here, and he's just right-clicking Shadow Fiend. Because he knows that if he does more of these right clicks, he can always remnant and start fighting. Okay? So he's playing really well. So you see that? Rain is frozen. Alright, let's see what he's doing here. So you see that after this, what he did, lane is freezing here, which is really nice because it's on the high ground. It's on your high ground. Now Shadow Fiend will rain. Okay. There's another thing which is happening right here. Let's play this. Alright. Alright, so right now he's... Alright, so this Shadow Fiend... remember Shadow Fiend is full HP, right? Full mana. He might raise the creep, okay? Because every time, you have to remember, a good Shadow Fiend, every time he will do this, okay? If you are very close to a creep, and if a Shadow Fiend can use his raise, okay? If Shadow Fiend can use his raise such that he gets a creep, and he does damage on you, a Shadow Fiend will almost always uses raise, okay? Almost always uses raise. So right now the Shadow Fiend is gonna do that, and I think this small mistake Storm did. So right now you see that this creep is low, right? If you are somewhere in this range, it is efficient for Shadow Fiend to use his raise on you, because he's gonna get this creep. He's guaranteeing this last hit of the creep, and he's guaranteeing harass on you. So I don't know why Storm's walking up. I think this is bad, but he's doing that. This guy's walking up. He's taking raise damage from him. Oh, I know why. Okay. Because this guy. Alright, so... Right? Generally, I look at all of these. I look at the minimap and stuff. But right now, I'm explaining too much, so I'm not looking at what's happening in the minimap. So what Storm did right here is bad. Okay? Don't do this shit. This will make you lose your lane. Like, right now... Storm is walking up here. If Shadow Fiend uses his medium raise, and then Storm keeps walking up, Shadow Fiend uses his melee range, melee raise, then Storm is taking a shit ton of damage, right? Why would you do that? And you're not getting anything out of this. You're not even getting a creep. So this is a really bad thing which he did, okay? He's walking up and doing this bullshit. He's 7k MMR Storm. He's really good. You might think this is a mistake, but this is not, because there's a reason for it, right? The reason is because this guy is trying to gank Shadow Fiends, okay? So Storm's trying to create an opportunity. That's the only reason he's doing that. Otherwise, he would not do this. It's just a bad decision. So you see that? He walks up, Shadow Fiend instantly uses a raise. Damage on him. And he might use melee, but Shadow Fiend sees he has a ward, so he's seeing it. I don't know if it's his ward. I don't know whose ward is this. Cakes. No, it's his ward. Oh, someone pinged him. Okay. So Shadow Fiend backed. So right now it's all right. Right now, what Storm did is all right in this very moment. But if there was no help, Shadow Fiend would just medium raise this guy, and this guy would have got fucking wrecked. Okay, but Shadow Fiend saw that there is an Oracle coming in, and he backed. So although that was a mistake, but it was not a mistake in this particular situation because Oracle was coming to gank, right? Or Shadow Fiend would have like wrecked the storm. So these are like so many things are happening in mid lane, right? So you have to watch all this. Okay, he knows he can't kill Shadow Fiend. Oh, he can. Okay, that is Oracle. I didn't know. Okay, there's a lot of 150 damage. Wow, I didn't know it does so much damage. I always max this. I don't max. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I do max Fortune's End. Anyway, whatever. It's fine. Shadow Fiend is fucking wrecked. And once this guy. Okay, he's fucking dead. Holy shit. Shadow Fiend's so fucking dead. He has a DDA rune. Someone should come and camp Shadow Fiend. If he does one raise, so Shadow Fiend has to be really careful. Because. Alright. So. Right now, Storm is like medium HP, so Storm can get fucked by Shadow Fiend with two raises, okay? And the only two raises that can help Shadow Fiend right now is medium raise and the melee raise, okay? This raise is useless, because if Storm jumps on you, he's going to be in this range. So, as soon as Shadow Fiend uses his medium raise, Storm will just jump on him and wreck his face, okay? With DD rune. With full mana. So this Shadow Fiend has to be really careful of not using his medium raise. And also he's still scary. So I think he's waiting. As soon as he uses... Okay, he didn't use the medium raise. Okay, that's a good raise. That was a good raise. He actually damaged Storm. So now you see that Storm can't jump on Shadow Fiend because Shadow Fiend will melee raise. You melee raise Storm and Storm is fucking dead. So that's fine. He played well. He needs a salve. He's not getting a salve. That sucks. Alright, whatever. So Storm's actually playing this matchup really well. Let's see. Let's forward this. Alright. What happened? Alright. So right now he's bottling up. He's fucking dead. If he comes close, he's fucking dead. Shadow Fiend's dead. There you go, dead. No way, he's fucking dead. That's it. Like, this is where supports come into play, right? Like, if it didn't have this, can be like 7k Shadow Fiend, and I could be like a 3k Storm Spirit. Well, if Storm Spirit is really bad, he can fuck it up. But this right now, Shadow Fiend should realize that. I don't know what MMR this guy is, but this guy should realize that he is a free kill to Storm right now, and there is no way he can go for this last hit. Like, if I was this Shadow Fiend right here and I saw Storm with a DD rune and full mana at level 6 when I am fucking level 5 and I don't have like boots or anything, there is no way I would go for this CS. Like, that's it. I will ask my support to come help me. And that's the problem. Like, this is where supports play a very important role. And the problem is, this is where a jungler becomes so painful. Right? Jungler fucks up mid lane players a lot. And people don't realize this. They're like, oh, fucking shitty mid lane player or whatever. Right? Now, the Shadow Fiend didn't play bad. Remember, the Shadow Fiend didn't play bad. The Oracle ganked him and he got fucked, right? The Shadow Fiend did not play bad at all. It was not a true one versus one, but the Storm played really well and he fucked. He didn't give a single CS to Shadow Fiend at level first two waves, right? Now, if the Shadow Fiend gets CS the first two waves, then Storm has a really hard time, right? He's gonna have a really fucking hard time because Shadow Fiend's just gonna get every fucking CS after that. This Storm will have to use his remnants to farm. But that didn't happen. This Storm played really well the first two waves and denied all kinds of all the CS the Shadow Fiend got. He played really well. And after that, Shadow Fiend, even though the first two waves he got denied, he can easily come back, Shadow Fiend. But this fucking Oracle came and ganked Shadow Fiend and he's wrecked. Now, the problem is, the only reason this is happening is because these guys have a jungling fucking druid, right? This jungler is a fucking pain in the ass because jungle heroes are shit because what they do is they make your safe lane unsafe, right? So the lion has to babysit the Slark. He has no other option. And what these guys did is these guys actually have a support, right? And problem is this guy's an anti-mage. Anti-mage is really, 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 really good at clock. Good against clock. Clock can't do shit against anti-mage. So this Oracle has all his time to go fuck up the mid lane. And these guys dual laned. So Queen of Pain and Nyx Assassin versus Slark and Lion. So it's going to be really hard. And Lion can't go and help Shadow Fiend at all. So the Shadow Fiend has to fend for himself. And he should realize this. Like, if I am Shadow Fiend this game, I know that if I don't win my... Like, if I get fucked that game, if I get fucked, that's it. I'm going to lose. Like, the only way what I can do is just stay back here and hope that you get some experience. Maybe go stack the jungle and stay back and ask Lion to like screw this lane, like leave this lane and come like the Storm's gonna play aggressive on Shadow Fiend, right? And you can ask the Lion, can you babysit me? And you get one kill of Storm Spirit and you're back in the game. Anyway, right now he's fucked instantly, wrecked. So this game, I wouldn't say it's like a proper game because there's so many things happening that's going against Shadow Fiend this game. So whatever. All right. So that's it. This game is so lost. Like there's no way these guys can come back. But Shadow Fiend is a hero that can always come back because he farms like fucking crazy. But anyway, this lane, he's gonna lose. Every time he has full mana, this guy's a free kill. Every single time. Alright. Oh my god, he just respawned and he died. That sucks. That sucks so much. It sucks so much. Poor guy. That's it. This is gone. Like, he can't do anything. He can be a fucking 8k MMR Shadow Fiend. Well, 8k MMR Shadow Fiend. The difference between 8k... Not 8k, but basically 6k and a 4k Shadow Fiend. Like, if I played Shadow Fiend, I would have probably been, like, the same guy. Like, fucking, I would have sucked ass, right? But a 6k Shadow Fiend will probably get all this. The first two waves, he would have done something or the other and got the last hits against that Storm, right? And he would not be in a weak position. He would have had his bottle earlier. So all these things matter. People think, like, laning is nothing. But in mid lane, the first two waves, laning is everything. But of course, if you have really good supports and you have a good lineup like this, in this case, Oracle can do a lot of shit, right? Because he's so free. Like, Clock can't do shit against Anti-Mage. So, in this game, Storm is in an advantage because his supports can do a lot. And their support can't do anything because he has to babysit. He didn't tower dive. Anyways, fuck. Shadow Fiend just gonna keep feeding. Like, what can he do? He doesn't even need Oracle. Right now, Shadow Fiend is a fucking free kill. He should realize this. Like, what can he do? He should ask the Lion to come help him. Game over. After this, like, they can't do anything. The only way they can do is, like, Clock gets off some kills and Slark somehow snowballs. And he's not doing that well because they dual lane against Slark, right? And they fucking wreck that safe lane. So this game is going way too much. And all because of this jungler. This guy fucking picked jungler. That's the only reason. The only way they can come back is if this jungler pays off, right? I don't think he's going to pay off when a Storm is fucking snowballing. Storm's going to drop his bottle into this guy. This guy's going to refill the bottle. There you go. This is something you should always do. You should give the bottle to a guy who's TPing and the bottle will automatically get filled up if you didn't know. Okay, he backed. He knows that he can't go on a clock. Okay, that's good. Oh my god. Man, that sucked. He's gonna die. Sad. So fucking sad. Alright, this game is over. Like, there's no point in, like, watching more of this. Like, if you are a Storm Spirit player and you can't do this after this gets started, if you can't win the game, you fucking suck ass, right? You basically are bad at mechanical skills. Like, after this, you fucking win, right? Maybe Lone Druid can go mid. Right now, Lone Druid's probably going mid. And this guy's gonna, like, jungle or some shit. He doesn't even have boots. He's a free kill to Storm every single time. Lone Druid is not a free kill because he's level 8 and he has a bear and he's fucking 1200 HP. So he's safe against Storm. That's probably what they're going to do. They're going to put Lone Druid mid and Shadow Fiend's just gonna jungle. So probably Shadow Fiend's like retarded teammates are gonna be like, oh, what a new fucking Shadow Fiend, sucks ass feeding Storm Spirit. That's not how it works, guys. This game, you would have fucking lost as Shadow Fiend. If you didn't get those first two waves of CS, you would have fucking lost. And all because this team picked like shit, while this team picked really well. Simply because of that. It's gonna keep happening. Like, nothing. Like, this guy, this hero needs farm. Okay? Wow, the Lion played really well. Lion. Man, well played. He ulted that storm. He got a lot of gold from that shit. Okay, they fucked up. These guys. This is Arteezy. Wait. This is actually Arteezy. YB is Arteezy. Oh my lord, that is actually... Dire's bottom tower. That is actually Arteezy, isn't it? That is most definitely Arteezy. I am so sure of it. This is fucking Arteezy. That's Arteezy, boys. There's no way. This guy has so much farm. And his name is YB. This is Arteezy. He's playing well. Alright. This game, Arteezy is... It doesn't matter. You can have Arteezy as a safe lane carrier. Maybe he can maybe carry. Because this fucking Arteezy farms like crazy. And he knows how to play well. But I don't think you can win this game. This game is so fucking lost. And the only reason they lost is... Because this fucker picked jungle. Now, this guy needs farm. Okay, this guy needs farm. This guy needs farm. This guy needs farm, okay? And this guy, the problem is, this guy needs farm. Everyone needs farm. This guy's the only guy who can farm in the lane. Maybe this guy can also farm in the lane. But if he farms lane, both of these guys are gonna be, like, vulnerable, right? And Shadow Fiend cannot farm the lane because he's a free kill to Storm. So, this team is losing simply because of the picks and because Shadow Fiend fucked up the first two waves. He couldn't get his last hit. And it's really hard, right? Because if you remember when I showed you what happened, Shadow Fiend was like really, really, really low. Like he does 40 damage level 1, while this guy does like crazy amount of damage. So what some people do is like they go branch build. They get two branches on Shadow Fiend and go level 1 raises. And they just get the raise damage and get a bottle rush. You can do that. Like, if you have a team like this, you should try that. You should just get two branches. See, we can't do anything. You can't even stay in lane. Alright. You should get, if you're Shadow Fiend, you should get two branches and a pool tango and just use raises to last it. There's no way you can deny when you have raises if you play correctly, right? Use your raises to last it and get your bottle. Instantly get your bottle crow, and then you fucking win the game. Anyway, that's something Quaqua does as a Shadow Fiend level 1. Anyway, this game, he's just farming. Like, Storm's doing the shit. Okay. Okay, Arteezy's fucking dead. Alright, so that's what he's doing. Basically, he's staying off the map. Like, if you notice this, if Shadow Fiend shows up in the map, he goes to kill Shadow Fiend. But when Shadow Fiend's not there, he's staying off the map and farming jungle or something. Because every time Storm is not visible in the map, the enemy can't farm. Because right now, what will happen is, say, this guy is farming bottom only because he saw Storm Spirit top. So he knows he's safe bottom. Now, if Storm Spirit shows top, then the entire team can farm bottom and mid. But the Storm Spirit, if he's hidden, and he has now a regen room, that's another problem. And he has a TP, and he's hidden somewhere and he's farming the jungle. They can't even farm anywhere because they're like, where the fuck is Storm Spirit? I can't farm. So there's another thing you can keep doing, and this guy does this. He probably lives his life in the jungle with a TP scroll with him. I think a TP is coming to him. There you go, a TP. This is what he's gonna do. He's just gonna stay in the jungle, keep farming the jungle. And now Shadow Fiend can't farm anywhere. Like, Shadow Fiend doesn't see Storm, he can't do shit. He has to like probably get another support or something and farm with him. There you go, getting another support with him. And now Storm is probably trying to kill people. That's a free kill. Okay. Clock is dead, but Slark survived. A chink in my armor.
I'll take that. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Where's Shadow Fiend? Oh, he's actually pushing bottom. Because he saw Storm mid. So you see that, they don't actually see, but they see the mini-map. They're like, alright, Storm's mid. I'm safe. Right now, Shadow Fiend's not safe. He should back. He doesn't even see Storm Spirit. Like, Storm Spirit can just TP. They can just fucking kill Shadow Fiend. Alright, Shadow Fiend's gonna feed. Oh, he has Slark. Okay, that's fine. They're just 5-manning right now. Alright, he has Clock, so his entire team is here. This is a good fight, because his team is here, Shadow Fiend's team is here, but Storm is gonna pick up. Let's see what Storm's doing. Alright. Right now, he has no mana to join the fight, so which is probably why he didn't TP. He stacked this camp, and he's joining the fight anyway. That is weird. Maybe he's bottle. Does he have a bottle? I don't know. Oh, he has no bottle charges. So he's going for the invis rune. Looking for me. And has to back off. He can kill him. Bah, that's a bad idea. That was so bad by Storm. Wasting time. He's wasting time. He should just go farm. Like, there's no point. He could have not killed the Shadow Fiend at all. Unless he gets some help. And his help was... They were all here. They're all, like, here. So, yeah. Radiant's top tower is under attack. He's farming the stack he just made. He wants his Orchid. Once he gets his Orchid, like, this entire team is free kill. Probably not Lone Druid. Gets a lucky bear entangle. But everyone else is a free kill. So that's it right now. This is basic Storm game after this. Once you get such a fast Orchid. He has Tread, Soldering, and Orchid at almost, like, I don't know, 16 minutes. Game is so over. So right now, the enemy team has to 5-man, or 3-man, or 4-man, or shit like that, because this fucking Storm is out of control, right? And they can't do anything, and AM has Battle Fury. This game is so lost, like, unless there's a miracle that happened, this game is so fucking lost. He's going top to farm. He sees someone in lane, Slark, he sees Slark. I don't know if he's going, he didn't check him though, I don't know why. Or maybe I see it, because... I have both Fog, both teams. I should do Dire. No, I should do Radiant.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
No, I don't see. Yeah, I don't see the entire map. Yeah.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He's trying to push this tower out. Let's see how much HP the tower is. Yeah, he's trying to push the tower out. This team can do a lot bottom. Now they know Queen of Pain and Storm are top. What is Slark doing? Or Arteezy? He's going mid because he knows they're both top. Now he knows the tower. He has to back. Because he knows they have a TP. And he can't be close to the tower. What is Storm doing? He's still farming top. See, they're all looking at the mini-map. So you see that? Storm is here. Storm, Queen of Pain is here. Everyone's bottom. Everyone is outside of where Storm is. Because Storm is really strong. So everyone's like... Exactly the opposite part of the map. So alright, so this is the game. This is it, I think. Okay, he's coming. He waited for this entire time. There you go, fucking dead. Okay, Lion's here. Okay, he's fucking dead. Oh, he ulted. So he was waiting, and instantly all his teammates came. And he was able to ulti. Slark just survived. Arteezy survived with, like, such low HP.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I thank you.
This is what you should do when you're playing against Storm. A lot of people make this mistake, right? Alright, a lot of people make this mistake. Like, say a hero is snowballing, right? Say some hero like Storm is snowballing. They're like off. Like, say Shadow Fiend. Say I am Shadow Fiend, right? A lot of people just go like, oh, I'm fucking Shadow Fiend. Let me go farm. They keep trying to farm and catch up. It's not gonna work out, right? Because you're gonna farm, you're just gonna feed Storm more. What you gotta do instantly when this happens is you have to start grouping up, right? And you have to start baiting. So Storm wants kills. He got his Orchid. He's not going to farm with his Orchid, right? He's going to want kills. So you have to use Shadow Fiend as bait. You have to use Slark as bait. So they can literally use Shadow Fiend as bait. So because Storm is going to be like, I want to kill Shadow Fiend. I want to kill someone. And they can just use him as bait. and just kills Storm every single time he jumps on Shadow Fiend, right? And a good Storm like me, okay, this fucking Shadow Fiend's dead. See, he's dumb. Like, why would he farm there? Where is his team? Where is his team? Oh, his team was right here, but I don't think they were close. Okay, whatever. It's too late. Okay, he shouldn't be. It's still like really like. If I'm like the only reason Storm went in there because he had vision that there were no one close by, but a good Storm will not go and fall for baits. Like, a good Storm will know a difference between a bait, between a bait and an easy kill. So Shadow Fiend there was an easy kill because he had vision and no one was nearby. But if someone's like baiting, like a good Storm Spirit or a good high level player will not fall for the bait, right? Alright, so what you do as a Storm Spirit right now is when the team is 5-manning, you don't fall for the baits. You don't just go kill. A lot of people do this. They get an Orchid, they get a really good start, right? And what they do is, if the enemy is good, they start grouping up and they start baiting heroes like Shadow Fiend, right? And this Storm just goes, tries to kill Shadow Fiend and dies every single time. And he's like, fucking shit team, it's not helping me or whatever. You're just falling for baits. What you do right now is, fuck it. They're together. Your entire team to start using the space. When they're 5-manning, you have to split the map and farm like fucking crazy. Every single hero supports everyone. Start farming, right? Of course, if you have a team that doesn't get any advantage with farm, like if you have some shitty team, then you don't farm. You just push towers and look for kills, right? But if you have a good team that gets help from help using farm, then you just farm. AM very good with farm, Storm very good with farm, Oracle very good with farm, Queen of Pain very very good with farm, Nyx Assassin very good with farm. So all of these heroes can farm. They don't have to fireman, right? They don't have to go and start fighting. You have to use his advantage to just farm, which is what they're doing right now. Only this guy can farm, and the only reason he farmed is they know the Storm's top. So that's why he's farming. So every player is looking at the minimap and noticing like what's happening, what do we do, and stuff like that. He can't kill any of these heroes. You see that? Whoa, what'd I miss? Becomes so troublesome to farm.
Under attack.
They don't have vision? Are you fucking kidding me?
Zip. Boom, there it goes.
Oh my god, this guy got a Yules. That's the power of that's the power of Shadow Fiend. He can farm like fucking crazy. And he gets Yules, he fucking kills Storm Spirit. Well, the Storm is on. He's a 7k Storm, is what I heard, but he's making way too many mistakes. Like, why would he jump there on a Slark? Like, I wouldn't jump. I don't know, he's a 7k Storm, man. Some Peruvian player, apparently. But he's making way too many mistakes. But obviously, I am looking at his game, so I'm more free to think. I'm not playing the game. But that's a mistake. Why would he jump there? He knows his entire team. He's alive. But the thing is, like, I know why. He didn't expect Shadow Fiend Yules. Shadow Fiend, I think, just got the Yules at that moment. I'm sure. Let's see. He didn't expect Shadow Fiend to have Yules. That's the only reason he died there. Yeah, you see that? Shadow Fiend had just gotten the Yules. So he didn't expect Shadow Fiend to Yules there. So he just thought, well, actually, I can kill this guy. Because they used all their spells, right? These guys used every single spell. He used Hook. So Lion used Stun. Slark uses Dark Pact. So. And he fucked up. Alright. Anyway, right now, Anti-Mage is going to carry. And this guy is making a mistake. If I was Storm right now, I would use all this space to just farm the shit out of the map. I would increase my GPM to 700 GPM or something and start farming like crazy. This camp. Actually, this camp. And I'll push this lane here because I want AM to farm my jungle. Arteezy is doing a lot of work. Holy shit. It's fucking Arteezy. Alright, so what is this guy doing? Let's forward. Alright. That's the problem. Like, Lone Druid fucks up Storm so much. In all honesty. See, he's doing. What was he doing right now? I wanna know. Oh, he's farming. Alright, that's fine. Okay, they don't have wardens. Lone Druid, that hero, man. It fucks up Storm so much. One. Storm can't do anything. He has to run away. That's actually a good hero against Storm. And Lone Druid has a lot of HP, base HP, this hero. Look at that. Fucking 1700 HP. You can't eat through that as a Storm. Unless you have, like, Bloodstone. Alright. So this is it. Let's see what he's doing. Alright. Fucking Slark is dead. That was so... Arteezy doing clowny shit. See? Like, out of position is the only way you can kill him now.
Let the fun begin!
Arteezy probably laughing his ass off for that mistake. He didn't expect Storm to be there for some reason. I don't know why. That's what he was saying. Now he should just farm. That's what I would do. Okay, Bear has... So right now the jungle hero is paying off because he got the Radiance. So somehow it paid off, but generally it shouldn't pay off. If your allies are good, they're just gonna like fucking... wreck your face, right? They're gonna do all kinds of crazy shit. Well, the allies will... you can't, like, if you go jungle and you don't get your items quickly, then, you know, Storm Spirit can just win the game. But this guy made some mistakes. Like, he went to kills that he shouldn't have gone for. He farmed a little slower. Like, this is really low. 143 CS in 23 minutes is really bad. As a snowballing Storm, he had complete free farm. So if you watch Sumail, you will know this. Like, he won't do shit like this. As soon as he sees five manning, he starts farming like crazy, gets his Bloodstone, gets a BKB, and starts wrecking face. He accelerates his farm. Okay, he missed. Okay, he got it. So previously, this is a nerf to Storm, actually. So previously, Storm could like use ulti and he gets like flying vision, so he could use his orchid in the air. Now you don't get vision, you get like really shitty vision, and you only get normal vision, so you can't use it in the air unless you ball through him, right? And shift Q your orchid.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
He's fucking dead.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Man, this game is long as fuck. I didn't see what Storm did. Okay, that's a free kill.
I'm over here.
Oh my god, Peanut Pain is dead. You do not fuck with the bear. Look at that bear, dude. Yeah, it's fucking wrecking his face. Look at. Oh my god, that entangle. This guy's an entangle lord. Holy shit.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, hey, that was a bad trade. Why would he trade with illusions? It's dumb. I would just walk out, pay my mana. It's actually a bad idea. There's no mana. Arteezy does random shit like this. Farming with no mana. Okay. He's fine, I think. Money changes hands. Okay, back. It's nice. He's playing really well, but he's playing really greedy. Arteezy is a greedy fucking farmer. Holy shit. Farming with zero mana. That's basically you dying, Slark. Does he have mana for... Yeah, he doesn't have mana for this shit. He's using his Q too, like look at this. Arteezy is like the most greediest farmer, but that's what makes him really good. Is his greedy farming. Oh my god, this guy made some next level plays. Alright, let's see what he did. Took his haste rune. He hears a Roshan sound. He's losing a lot of HP, look at that. He got the... Oh my god, this guy fucked up. How did he not pick up the immortality? He fucked up so much. A bad idea, but he's just doing it anyway. Okay, safe. Does this what you do as a storm spirit is always go on the supports, always never go on the carry unless you're snowballing like crazy. Right now the storm isn't snowballing anymore.
I'm over here. This is but a short cycle.
This guy is useless without the bear, so there's that. There's Slark hitting, he knows, Arteezy knows he has no mana, but he's trying to do as much damage as possible. Now SF is getting space in between all of this. He's just AFK farming, getting his Scotty. Look at the farm. SF is coming back in last hits. This storm is not playing well. Like I think this guy's playstyle is more of ganking, snowballing. He's not like a blitz type. Blitz is like really good storm. This guy they say like he's 7k storm. He's amazing. I don't think he's not anywhere close to.
Over here now.
Okay, he jumped here because he hoped like okay. There's a reason for that. So he cleared this camp, and SFs are always greedy. They will go and kill this creep. And I think that's why he went. He's hoping he's actually here, and he actually finds him, I think. There you go, you found him.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Over here now. Told you a storm was coming.
This is a really good play, because he knows that he's going to... SF killed this camp right here. He killed here and then he's gonna farm this, so he instantly TP'd and walked. So this is just these are some things like you learn as you play more. Like this is something I learned from my coach. Like they do this. And I was like, yeah, we can do this. But anyway, these are what separate you from a normal player and a good player. This kind of risky too, but cause if someone else was here, of course he saw like Lion and everyone bottom. But anyway. Did it well, good job. But Blitz is like more calculated. I think Blitz is much, much better than this guy, even though he's Blitz is 7k too. This guy is like, they consider him as like the best storm server. He's nowhere close to Blitz. Blitz will by now have at least 200 CS. When he's snowballing like this, he would know that you can't like waste time like this. Like he's what? Look at this. Why would you do this? Waste of time. He wasted all his mana for a lion kill because he wanted the lion. The Blitz won't do this. He would farm somewhere. He'll go farm top, farm these, like create some map pressure by farming. I don't know. I don't think this guy is really a great storms player. Anyway,
top tower is under attack.
Probably mechanically skilled though. The laning, he was really good. He's mechanically really skilled. Not the best storm spirit player.
Here I am.
Alright. That's the difference between like say Arteezy plays carry versus another carry. Arteezy will be like super efficient, like moving around the map farming. Everyone can right click creeps, but Arteezy will right click creeps at the right time, so he clears the jungle at the right time, so he clears the wave and then comes back to jungle. Jungle is again respawn and stuff like that. He just like that's what that was. You have to be efficient, not just like know how to play a hero mechanically. Okay, that was a good TP. He's gonna what is he doing? Okay, he's going on clockwork. He's fucking dead. Why I would never go on Shadow Fiend there with like zero mana, and Shadow Fiend didn't use his Yules. It was so bad by the storm. I don't know, he's making a lot of mistakes. I would kill that clock and just back off, because there's not, no, you can't kill anyone else there. Oh, he bought back? Oh, Bloodstone, I forget. I mean, SF should know. He should look at the timer, right? Did he not look at the timer? See, it clearly says. Oh, he was expecting this guy will save him. He's fucking dead. Alright, whatever. This game is, like, pointless now. Let's look at another game. Let's look at Sumail's games. Sumail Dota.